everyone. I'm going to read you a story today from this book. It's a huge book full of Disney stories. But the story I've chosen for you today is not about princesses. It's a story that I know some of you in yellow class will enjoy. And hopefully some of you in the rest of the school might enjoy it too. Okay? Okay, so the story I've chosen for you is Dinosaur. So I haven't watched this film, but after reading this story, I might watch it at some point. So I'll read the story to you. Sometimes the smallest things make the biggest changes in the lives of others. That's exactly what happened 65 million years ago when a dinosaur egg containing an iguanodon was taken from the safety of its nest. After Aladar's friends and family were attacked by a group of carnotaurs, the egg in which Aladar lived was miraculously transported over land, sea and sky to a distant island. Landing in the midst of a lemur clan, the egg was the object of much attention. The curious Pleo was the first to investigate. "Dad, come look," called Pleo to the older monkey. The egg was beginning to crack. She watched as the baby iguanodon entered the world. "It's a cold-blooded monster," warned Yar, the elder lemur. "Things like that eat things like us for snacks." Pleo didn't believe him for a minute. "Look at that sweet little face. Does that look like a monster to you?" she asked. Yar couldn't resist the adorable Aladar. And that's how a dinosaur came to be raised by a clan of lemurs. The sound of screaming and chittering could be heard throughout the forest. Aladar was chasing the young lemurs through the trees and was quickly gaining on them. But the screams were screams of delight as they laughed and played with their fun-loving dinosaur friend. "Pick on someone your own size," Aladar groaned, pretending to be afraid, while Suri and the other lemurs jumped all over him. Aladar enjoyed pretending to be afraid of his little friends. "Hurry up," said Pleo as she interrupted their playtime. "You don't want to miss the annual courtship ritual." As the little lemurs scampered away, Aladar set out to find his friend Zini, one of the eligible bachelors. Swinging from vines high in the ritual tree, everyone seemed to have found the perfect match. Everyone, that is, except poor Zini. "Don't worry," said Aladar. "You'll find someone next year." As Zini walked away, Pleo gave Aladar a hug. Zini wasn't the only bachelor left in the clan. Aladar was a lone dinosaur in a family of lemurs. Pleo longed for Aladar to meet someone of his kind as well. "Oh, Aladar, if only there were someone on the island for you," she said. "Come on, Pleo," responded Aladar. "What more could I want?" Hiss! Hiss! Aladar and Pleo looked upward. Something strange was happening. Birds squawked overhead and the lemurs chittered wildly as a meteor shower began. They had never seen anything like it. "Something is wrong," warned Yar, sniffing the air. The rumbling sounds were growing louder and louder. "Where's Suri?" asked Pleo, desperately looking around for her child. At that moment, they saw a huge fireball hit the earth. The force of the impact was so great that it caused a tidal wave, which was rolling towards them faster and faster. "Run, Aladar, run!" Pleo cried from Aladar's back as the dinosaur ran toward the trees to find her little Suri. Aladar ran as fast as he could, carrying his lemur family to safety. When they reached the cliff, they took a deep breath and jumped into the water below. Aladar and the lemurs swam to the surface and clung to each other until they were safely on dry land. Exhausted, they looked back. Their island had been destroyed. "Come on," Aladar said. "We can't stay here." So they began to move, uncertain about their destination, but knowing that they must find a new place to live. They didn't know what had happened, but they knew that things would never be the same. They walked for miles and miles. Eventually, they came across a herd of various dinosaurs who were on a journey of their own. The herd was headed to the nesting grounds. The leader of the herd was an iguanodon named Kron. He was a tough dinosaur who pushed the herd on relentlessly. Cron had a sister. Her name was Nera, and Aladar thought she was beautiful. "Keep those legs moving or you'll get left behind," cautioned a feisty styracosaur named Ema. Ooh. Also in the group was an elderly brachiosaur named Baleen, who had a difficult time keeping up with the herd. They struggled to keep going as they crossed the desert. Suddenly, Ema cried, "The lake is over the hill! We made it!" But looking over the hill, they were shocked to see that the lake was dry. Fortunately, Aladar made a discovery. When Baleen pressed her humongous foot into the sand, water sprang up from underground. Aladar made sure that the younger dinosaur got plenty of water to drink. As they continued on the journey, the dinosaurs kept a careful watch for the dangerous carnotaurs lurking in the area. "Move!" ordered Cron. "What's wrong? Why are we moving?" asked Aladar. "It's the carnotaurs. They've got a mouthful of teeth and a very bad attitude," replied Ema, as they fell further behind the rest of the herd. Aladar sighed. They would never catch up. The stragglers soon came across Bruton, Cron's chief lieutenant, who had been injured and left behind. Aladar invited Bruton to join them in the cave, where they decided to seek shelter. "Come on your feet," he said, helping Bruton to the cave. Bruton couldn't understand why Aladar continued to encourage the others. "Why is he pushing them on with false hope?" he asked Cleo. "It's hope that has gotten us this far," she replied. Outside, the carnotaurs picked up the scent. When they attacked, Bruton bravely held them off so that Aladar and the others could escape.